You are looking at the Land Rover 90 by Matchbox. This particular version was released in 2007, I believe, as part of the new Superfast line that lasted a few years. This one with the silver trim and the black rims, white roof, has always been a favorite of mine. Probably my favorite version of this casting. And it's always been a collector favorite, as has this one. This is the Defender 110. I think it's first released in 2006. I'm guessing this is a 2007 or 2008 version, as you can tell by the metal roof, which has since been modified to a plastic roof. This was the recent Best of World release of the Land Rover 110, Defender 110, and that's always been a favorite as well. We profiled a pre-production of the, or showcased a pre-production of the newest version of the Land Rover 90, which is part of the latest Land Rover series from Matchbox, and we just got a set. I just got a set. We're going to open it up and take a look at it. This particular set came from Modelmatic. They are a hobby dealer out of the UK. The UK has seen the Land Rover series. It's a special six-car set. And Modelmatic has it. I think they still have some available for sale if you would like it, especially if you're in the UK. I would say that's a no-brainer to get the Land Rover set. It is Modelmatic.uk to get to their website. I'll also put a link down below in the comment section so you can take a look at that. But I've really been excited to look at these models. I got this a couple of days ago and haven't had a chance to look at it. But there is the Land Rover SVX, open top, front detailing, rear detailing. It's on large rims and it's plain green. So I like that British, it's not British racing green, right? Because it's not really a race car, but that's a, we call it British green. That might make you folks in the UK cringe a little bit, but nonetheless, it is good looking. We might be opening that in a little bit. Next is the Land Rover Discovery. Here, I'll move up just a bit so you can see the card. Land Rover Discovery in a police livery. And I think that's not a license, but it's made in the style of, what is it, Essex in the UK. So, since it has the side detailing, it doesn't have the front and rear detailing, but we'll look at that one too in a little bit. Next one, Land Rover Evoque, which is new for 2016. Just hitting some stores now. Those of you in the US, look at Dollar Tree. That batch is there with that and the Miata, but this is a different color and we'll be looking at that one as well. Just so if you want to see the back of the card, this is an international release. I don't know if there'll be any difference in the US release. The aforementioned Land Rover 90. Now this is a modified casting. We're going to take a look at that in just a minute, so we'll get into that. The other one, the Defender 110, also modified. We'll look at that. But I love the color on that. And by the way, front detail and, hood details. Nothing on the rear. And lastly, the Land Rover Freelander, which maybe predates the Evoque a bit. I guess the Evoque is a Range Rover, but not a casting we've seen a lot lately, but nice to see an updated version on nice looking rims. So let's open up a couple. I think the three we want to focus on most, I'm going to turn this on. Let's get through the ones that just maybe take one little rotation. So here is the Freelander. It does have headlight pieces and then a front and front grille in plastic here. And I'll go ahead and move back to the close-up. So side detailing. Trying to look, I have to look up close. Cody, I think I know who that person is. So that is the 90. Next, let's take a look at the SVX, which this may have been a concept. I don't know too much of the history of the SVX. I might be thinking of a Jeep concept. But I do like it in green, and I do like it on those darker rims. It has also been a model that has not been used much of late. But you can see some of that trim on the grill. It's kind of cool. And I really do, I'm always happy to see models that are in a plain color. I don't know if that's a big deal to anybody else, but whatever. I kind of like it, and I do like that trim in the back with the taillights and that little SVX on the back. And if anyone wants to help educate me on what the SVX actually is, I should probably do my homework. Here's the police car. Another model that I wonder if we see in the main line just because it's so much metal, and that seems like a no-no these days based on their budgets, which is a bummer, but I do like it in this police livery. My guess is some of you like the blue rims, others of you do not. Would I prefer it something different? Yeah, but I still think this is a really good looking model. I don't know too many police vehicles that sport blue rims, but maybe there should be more. So that is the Discovery, the Disco. Next, let's just, because of the colors, let's take a look. So the this right here is the Land Rover Evoque that is in the main line this year, just released in a bright orange. Good looking model. And kind of a metallic, what is it, like a metallic greenish color on the rims, dark green gray kind of color on the rims. So that is the mainline release. This is the Land Rover release. Some more, I mean, similar, but in a burnt orange with dark gray rims. And if you need to see the difference, and a cool little license on the back, or a little Evoque. So there's a tempo difference on there as well. So, but here's your comparison, and you can see that while they're similar, they're also quite different. In fact, they're a lot more different than I thought. That one was more of a, you know, one is definitely bright, but that's more of a copper color than just a burnt orange color. And I like those rims on it. So, two different Evoques now, which is kind of nice to see two different versions right out of the gate. More the merrier, I say, especially on castings like that, of the Evoque. All right, now let's get into these two. Let's start with the Land Rover Defender 110. We've shown this change on the blog. Been pretty positive for the most part. There's some concerns on some of the details. Now, let me just to start. Here's the original casting. This isn't the original version of the Land Rover Defender, but this is the original casting. As you can see, there's that intake. I can't remember the name of that intake, but on the passenger side, considering the left-hand drive, equipment, luggage up at the top in metal. And then I don't know if there's any other major things to point out on that particular model, but that is the first version, lasted for a few years until the second version came along. That intake gets switched over to the driver's side. Some more plastic is put in. The luggage and equipment stays the same, but now part of it is plastic attached to the window piece as part of the four-piece rule, right? And it's still a pretty tall model. I like that version right there. Now, last, the newest version, and we're going to put some side by side, is this one. Now, just talking about the actual Land Rover release, I like this color. I like the detail on the hood, and it has the front headlight detail, and I just think it's a very cool model. Now, what are the changes? Well, it starts with the plastic piece. It's still there, but now it's incorporated the light bar. And the reason this is, just so you know why they're doing this, is again, like it or not, agree with it or not, they're under budget constraints, as is Hot Wheels. They have to fall within a certain budget. That means four pieces only for basic releases like this. and only a certain amount of metal. And I'm all for keeping the bodies metal and the bases plastic. I don't like the other way around. So I'm glad that they're doing this. On another level, I mean, it's always unfortunate to see, but I think they're doing the best with what they've got. Now, I've shown you the details there. If you start looking, you'll start seeing more details, starting with the fact that this new version is shorter than the old version. So they've taken, if you look, on the old version, there's two bars on the roof piece. Now, there's only one. So they've cut it down a little bit. But I actually think it looks more like a Defender from that perspective. The Defender, this one is probably just a little too tall. So that shortens then the ladder piece. I think the wheel piece is a little bit smaller just because there's less to work with in the back. There is an interior, although it's hard to see on the new model. But there is an interior in there, so they didn't take the interior away. But everything's just a little bit shorter, and then you see the light piece is now part of the roof. So here's my feeling. I like this. I like the look of it. I like the height of it. I think that this new version, in a lot of ways, is better than the old version. I like the fact, too, that here, if I put it this way, I'm going to be able to get it pretty much at this straight-up angle. I like the fact that the clearance on the new version is higher, and I think it looks better that way. So I'm all for all those. You can see the grill's a little smaller, too. The roof piece probably leaves a little to be desired. The light bars is the light bar there up at the top, or the light piece, the roof lights could probably be just taken away, and I would have just assumed a smooth roof piece like you see on a lot of Defenders, and just take away the whole carrier up there and just go with a smooth roof piece. It's still, you know, the roof piece shows within that rack, but anyway. So that's the Defender 110. I like it, but there's a couple of details that I would give. Lastly, the Land Rover 90. This is new to me. I know that there's been some modifications, and I'm going to learn about them just as you guys do too. So, first off, obviously, metal roof. I figured that was going to happen because they have to eliminate a piece, and they can't have a separate roof piece. So there is a metal roof. I'm trying to look at anything else. I'm going to go up close right here. So the grill piece, okay, so just from, here, we'll put it like this. So this whole front, so this now little grill guard in the front is now part of the base, which makes sense. There is still a tow hook. But on this one, it's part of on the new one, it's part of the base. On the old one, it's part of the interior. So they've simplified that. The models appear to be the exact same size. Most of the detail is there, it appears, on the casting. And then I wanted to check the stance. Do they? So this one, so this metal piece right here on the base, this kind of lower piece, has been taken away, as you can see, and so the clearance on the new one seems higher, which on a Land Rover 90, check out the clearance on that one versus the clearance on this one. I'll take that. I like that a lot better. So I think if I had to guess, I like the ability to put more detail in this one, but I think I like this version better. Just an overall looks of the casting. So anyway, that is the new Land Rover set. I'm gonna photograph it, put it on the blog here in the next couple of days. I like it. Tell me what you think. Like I said, it's available right now at modelmatic.uk. I think they're the only ones that have it, and will soon be in the United States. I don't know what other countries might get it. Maybe Australia, I'm not sure. So let us know if you do see it. Talk to you later.